Srikanth, Adil Chemistry. In this video, we are discussing about mole concept. It is a new topic, and the concept of mole concept is belongs to stoichiometry. So, this is new topic we are discussing, and it is a backbone of complete physical chemistry. What we discussed, calculations and everything is this topic is completely based to the entire physical chemistry. So, in the mole concept. First, in the first lesson, we are discussing about measurements. So, in this, I just discussing about some measurements and conversions from one unit to another unit. In that, first one is a distance or a length. Distance or length. Distance or length. Okay, so you know very well we will calculate the distance in kilometers, meters, centimeters, millimeters, like that. So I will give conversion from one unit to another unit. So first one, 1 kilometer km. Here km means kilometer. 1 kilometer is equal to 10 cube meters, and it is equal to 10 power 4 decameters, and it is equal to 10 power 5 centimeters, and it is equal to 10 power 6 millimeters. Once again, see this. 1 kilometer is equal to 10 cube meters, and it is equal to 10 power 4 decameters, and it is equal to 10 power 5 centimeters, and it is equal to 10 power 6 millimeters. At the same time, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters, it is equal to 1000 millimeters. At the same time, 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeters. So this is the conversion of kilometers to millimeters, or meters to millimeters, or centimeters to millimeters. Next, actually for atoms or molecules, we will discuss the distance or length in terms of angstroms or nanometers or picometers. So at the same time, so 1 angstrom is equal to 10 power minus 8 centimeters, and is equal to 10 power minus 10 meters. 1 angstrom is equal to 10 power minus 8 centimeters or 10 power minus 10 meters. At the same time, 1 nanometer is equal to 10 power minus 7 centimeters or 10 power minus 9 meters. At the same time, 1 picometer is equal to 10 power minus 10 centimeters or 10 power minus 12 meters. So there are another conversions or another relation between angstroms and centimeters and meters, nanometers to centimeters meters, picometers to centimeters and meters. And we can give the relation between angstroms, nanometers and picometers. 1 angstrom is equal to 10 power minus 1 nanometer, and 1 angstrom is equal to 10 square picometers. 1 angstrom is equal to 10 power minus 7 minus 1 nanometer or 10 square picometers. Okay, at the same time, 1 nanometer is equal to 1 millimicron. 1 nanometer is equal to 1 millimicron. Okay, clear? And 1 nanometer is equal to 10 cube picometers. So these are conversion between angstroms to nanometers, nanometers to picometers, like that. So this is about the length. And next measurement is a temperature. What is temperature? So temperature we represent with capital T. So in the chemistry, capital T is indication of temperature and small t is indication of a time. So generally the temperature can be calculated or can be indicated in 4 different scales. Those are Kelvin scale, centigrade or Celsius scale, Fahrenheit scale, and another new one is Reaumur scale. What is Reaumur scale? Kelvin scale, centigrade scale, Fahrenheit scale and Reaumur scale. Here I just give one formula to convert the temperature from one unit to another unit, that is a के माइनस 273 इज डिवाइड बाय 2 5 सी बाय 5 एफ माइनस 32 बाय 9 दैट इज इक्वल आर बाय 4. सो हियर के मीन्स केल्विन स्केल, सी मीन्स सेंटीग्रेड और सेल्सियस स्केल, एफ मीन्स फारेनहाइट स्केल एंड केप्लर मीन्स रेमो स्केल. सो वी कैन कन्वर्ट टेम्परेचर फ्रॉम वन यूनिट टू अनदर यूनिट और वन स्केल टू अनदर स्केल. सो हियर के मीन्स केल्विन, के मीन्स केल्विन स्केल, सी मीन्स सेंटीग्रेड, एफ मीन्स फारेनहाइट एंड आर मीन्स रेमो स्केल. ओके एंड मोस्टली इन द इन दिस स्टैंडर्ड इन योर आई मीन इन द इंटरमीडिएट स्टैंडर्ड वी यूज द सेंटीग्रेड स्केल एंड केल्विन स्केल. हियर द रिलेशन बिटवीन सेंटीग्रेड स्केल एंड केल्विन स्केल इज इक्वल टू टेम्परेचर टी डिग्रीज इन सेल्सियस इज इक्वल टू टेम्परेचर प्लस 273 केल्विन. आई मीन इफ यू वॉन्ट टू कन्वर्ट द टेम्परेचर फ्रॉम सेल्सियस स्केल टू केल्विन स्केल यू जस्ट नीड टू ऐड टू द 273 टू द सेल्सियस स्केल. So for understanding, I just give one example to you. Suppose you know very well the freezing point of water is 0 degree centigrade. So if you want to convert the 0 degree centigrade into kelvins, you just add the 273 to the Celsius, resulting you get 273 kelvins. So the freezing point of water is either 0 degrees or 273 kelvins. At the same time, the boiling point of water is 100 degrees. When it is converted into the kelvins by adding of 273, you can convert into the kelvins, resulting you get 373 kelvins. So the boiling point of water in Celsius is 100 degrees, in kelvins 373 kelvins. Like that, you can convert the temperature from centigrade to kelvins. If by using this formula, you can convert the temperature from one unit to another unit. Next measurable property is pressure. So pressure, okay, the pressure can be represented with a capital P. Okay, so here in the pressure, basic unit for the pressure is atmosphere. So we call as atmospheric pressure. That is, so one atmospheric pressure is equal to 1.01325 bars. One atmospheric pressure is equal to 1.01325 bars. So this is the relation between atmospheric pressure to bars. At the same time, one atmosphere is equal to 1.01325 into 10 power 5 pascals. Here PA means pascals. At the same time, it is equal to 101.325 kilopascals. Okay, this is the second conversion. And next one is one atmosphere is equal to 1.01325 into 10 power 5 Newton per meter square. Newton per meter square. So here I want to one thing. 1 Pascal is equal to 1 Newton. 1 Pascal is equal to 1 Pascal is equal to 1 Newton per meter square. Okay. So based on this, we can this is the conversion of atmospheric pressure into Newton meter square. And next in torts. 1 atmosphere is equal to 760 torts. Okay, and one atmosphere is equal to 76 centimeters. At the same time, 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeters. So one atmosphere is equal to 760 millimeters. Okay, this is the conversion of atmospheric pressure into various units. At the same time, if you take the bar, one bar is equal to 10^6 dynes per centimeter square. 1 bar is equal to 10^6 dynes per centimeter square or 10^5 newtons per meter square or 10^5 pascals. So this is the conversion of bar. 1 bar is equal to 10^6 dynes per centimeter square or 10 power 5 newtons per meter square or 10 power 5 pascals. So these are the main units, main conversions about the pressure. So next measurable property is volume. So the volume can be represented by capital V. We call as volume. So volume generally calculates in liters. So 1 liter is equal to 1 decimeter cube. 1 liter is equal to 1 decimeter cube or 10 power minus 3 meter cube or 10 cube centimeter cube or 10 cube cubic centimeters or 10 cube mls. 1 liter is equal 1 decimeter cube or 10 power minus 3 meter cube or 10 cube centimeter cube or 10 cube cubic centimeters or 10 cube mls. Here 1 centimeter cube or 1 cubic centimeter is equal to 1 ml. So 1 centimeter cube is equal 1 cubic centimeter, that is equal to 1 ml. So next one is a mass. Next measurable property is a mass. It will be represented with a small m or small w. Okay, so in mass, generally mass can be calculated in a grams or kilograms. So 1 kilogram is equal to 1000 grams or 10 cube grams. That is equal to, that implies at the same time 1 gram is equal to 1000 milligrams. 1 kg is equal to 1000 grams. At the same time 1 gram is equal to 1000 milligrams. So this is the conversion of units of mass from one unit to another unit. So next one is energy. Energy. Okay, generally energy can be calculated in joules or x or calories or electro volts. So the units of energy is joules, x, calories and electro volts. So 1 joule is equal to 10 power 7 x, that is equal to 0.239 calories. At the same time 1 joule is equal to 6.25 into 10 power 18 electro volts. At the same time 1 calorie is equal to 4.184 joules. At the same time 1 electro volt is equal to 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 joules. So here I want to mention one more thing. It will be very useful in a thermodynamics. 1 liter atmosphere is equal to 100 joules. What is 1 liter atmosphere is equal to 100 joules. So this is about the energy. And next one is a density. Next measurable property, that is a density. So the units of density is a gram per centimeter cube or kilogram per meter cube. 1 gram per centimeter cube is equal to 10 cube kilograms per meter cube. So the units, the relation between units of density is 1 gram per centimeter cube is equal to 10 cube kilograms per meter cube. And next and last is a next units is a speed for or velocity. This is the last measurable property I want to discuss here. So speed or velocity. So generally the units for speed for velocity is a meter per second or a centimeter per second. These are the units of speed or velocity of units for speed or velocity. Here I want to discuss one more one thing, that is velocity of light. We can represent with the capital C. So capital C is a indication of velocity of light. C means velocity of light. So for velocity of light we have some fixed constant values, that is 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second or 3 into 10 power 10 centimeter per second. So these are the units about the velocity of a light, and these are the some measurable properties we use in a complete physical chemistry. So these concept is very, very important for entire physical chemistry. These are the backbone units for physical chemistry. Okay students, this is about measurable properties. In the next video we are discussing about significant figures. Okay students, if you like my concept, please subscribe to my channel. Please like and share my videos. Thank you.